Hello, I'm Graham and I do hope everyone's having a great day. Welcome to this tutorial video where I'm going to show you how to extend the range you can get between your camera and your tablet using the Panasonic remote app. In this case I'm using the Panasonic FZ300 or 330, which will normally connect to the tablet or smartphone over a distance of about 10 meters or 30 feet. But if you're shooting through double glazed windows which have got the energy saving coating on them, you might find that that is reduced even further. So I needed a method to extend the range of the camera to the smart tablet. So I came up with the idea of using an old router as a local access point. Now normally the router would be mains power, but I'm using here a power bank and a USB to 9 volt or 12 volt in this case switch unit. So this is a USB to DC 9 volt or 12 volt. This particular router is a D-Link which is powered by 9 volt. So I'm going to power it from the 9 volt operation of this unit. You can get dedicated power supplies which are USB to the usual 5.5 by 2.1 connector which will go into the back of the modem. So if you've got a 12 volt enabled one, then you can just get a USB to 12 volt power adapter which are fairly cheap. So this was an old wireless network that I had before we upgraded to fiber broadband, so any router will actually do. You can actually get USB powered routers which would even be better than having to use an adapter, but that would incur an additional cost where I had this lying around in an old cupboard. We can see here now that I've got the router being powered from the USB power bank via that 9 volt converter from USB to 9 volts, so the router is now powered up. You might have to go up into your setup menu of your router, depends on the type, so that you can use the local wireless network without connecting to the internet. Obviously there's no internet connected to this, we're just using the Wi-Fi side of this and the fact that you can use it as a local area network. The first thing to do is to set up the tablet to communicate with the router. Now I've set up the router with its own password, which is a simple password because you're going to have to enter it from your smart tablet, so you don't want a complicated password, you just need one that you can access your router with. Obviously you're not going to go to the internet with the router, so security really isn't an issue in this case. In fact you could set it up without a password if you wanted to. So I'm going to connect the tablet to the router by going into the settings option, looking at Wi-Fi. It's currently connected to the house internet, so I need to change that connection over to this particular router, which is the D-Link. So I'm going to just click on D-Link. It's going to ask me to enter the password, so I'm going to enter the password for this particular router. We've got the tablet now communicating with the router. Now we have to establish a connection between the camera and the smartphone via the router, so I'll show you that next. So to connect the camera to the tablet via the router, we need to go into the Wi-Fi menu, so that's on the setup menu, page 1 of 5. We want to look at the Wi-Fi function, we want to set up a new connection, remote shooting and view, and now we need to change the method of connection. So instead of applying a direct connection to the tablet, we're going to choose the network. So you press the display button to bring up the via network option, press menu set to change that, and then we're going to look for it in the list of Wi-Fi available hotspots. So from list you can see that we've got our D-Link router there. We need to select that, press menu set. It says please enter the encryption key, so that is the password again for the router. So this is where you need to have that simple password. So now the camera is connected to the tablet, we need to launch the image app on the tablet. So if I launch the image app, let it go through its operation. You can now see that it's connected to the FZ330 with its own identifier. Now we're going to select remote operation. One's where the lens may extend. And now if I just move everything in view, we've got the tablet communicating to the camera via the router. So I can change things like the white balance, and that will respond on the camera. Use the return key to come back to the home menu. Change the ISO. Of course, you can record video or you can shoot stills. So that is how you would connect the camera to your tablet over an extended range using the router. To get your total distance, you've got something like 30 meters between your tablet and router, and then providing the router is within the 10 meters of the camera, you'll find you've got something like a 40 meters total distance overall. That's why we use the power bank to power up the router, so you can have that router set in between the camera and your smart tablet, perhaps out in the garden or on a location. Now, you don't have to go through that linking procedure every time you want to use the camera and your router. All you have to do is establish a connection between the tablet or your smartphone and the router, and you'll find it in your history list. So I'm just going to click on D-Link. So it will remember the password you've set. It will connect to the router. So we got D-Link connected. And now I can start the camera by going into the Wi-Fi menu. But this time, instead of a new connection, we want to select a destination from history. And here I've got the D-Link connected to the smart tablet, which is the SMT710. So I just need to press the menu set button on that. It will ask me to start the image app. So here on the tablet, just need to start the image app one more time. And the tablet will find the camera, ignore the fact that it's looking for a QR code. It's going to look for the direct connection through the router. So it's now connected to the camera. And we're now again connected in the recording mode. So again, I can take pictures or I can shoot video. So hopefully that's been useful. I'll put a link to the setup in my photographic blog. I'll put that in the video description below. If you are a new viewer to the channel, please do click that subscribe button and have a look at my photographic blog, and there's an invitation there to join the group that received the fortnightly newsletter. So until the next video, thanks very much for watching. Please take care, and I'll see you all in the next one.